owned the castle after his brother George built the Bear and Clarence Towers.
Talking of towers, Richard was a very cunning man. He locked his two nephews in the Tower of London so he could take the throne, and they were never seen again.
Unbelievable.
Over there is John Dudley. He was a Tudor. After inheriting the castle, he left it to rot in order to pursue his own hunt for power.
How dare he?
Well, that's funny. That portrait seems to be empty. How peculiar.
That's because it's supposed to be you. You were the next owner of the castle after it was given to you by King James I. Go on.
Oh, yes.
I inherited the castle from Fulk. From then on, the owners were all Grevilles, right up until 1978. There's the other Robert Greville.
Greetings, warriors. I am Princess Ethel Fleda. I laid the foundations of Warwick Castle over 1,000 years ago, in the year 914. There was a great battle between us, the Anglo-Saxons, in the south, and in the north, the Vikings. In order to hold back the Vikings, I built fortresses. In 1927, the Anglo-Saxons had conquered and united the surrounding lands to form England. 1 century later, a great threat approached this new kingdom.
Yes, a great threat indeed. In 1066, I, William, Duke of Normandy, at the Battle of Hastings, and claimed my rightful title, King of England. Whilst crushing the resistance in the north, I commanded that a Morton Bailey castle be built at Warwick, in case I needed to retreat. Of course, I did not. The next 200 years saw the castle undergo huge transformations. It was at the heart of several wars and many knights.
The last 200 years saw the transformation of the castle into the imposing stronghold you see before you. During the Wars of the Roses, Warwick was a seat of power for one reason. Me. I, Richard Neville, Earl of Warwick, also known as the Kingmaker.
The building was brought to life last week. Fulk spent the equivalent of £8 million rebuilding the castle. 30 years later, civil war raged once more. Warwick became a prime target for the king, but I swore no royalist would step foot inside the castle ever again. A fierce battle broke out. Watch out! Eventually, support was found from the south. Victory was ours.
Post-Civil War England was a very different place. The next generation of Grevilles, including myself, Francis Greville.
Thank you.